of the main deck. If you are using the rear stairway, please be advised that once
in October of last year, I just completed a performance of Bryony Lavery's Frozen in Los Angeles. My manager flew over to see it and she said, "That's it, I want you in New York." I came over here to pitch Frozen to Broadway producers. The response was amazing and I never left New York. Isn't she magnificent? Standing here now for over a century, greeting immigrants here at this gateway of opportunity. My name is John Perkis, and welcome to Diary of a Failed Actor. But here we are talking about actors moving to New York for their career. Why would you do that? Why would you choose New York as opposed to Los Angeles? As I mentioned in last week's episode on Los Angeles, I didn't really feel at home there. I couldn't really settle there. This again is why I say it is so important. You get a feel for the city before you close shop wherever you're coming from and look to move there permanently. Actors from London or from Sydney or from any other part of the world first encounter New York. A lot of the time what's happened is they've come over here with a production, whether it's a transfer from the West End, from the Royal Shakespeare Company, from the National Theatre. They get a taste for the city. The city gets a taste for them. If you're coming in with one of those productions, management and agents will definitely flock to see them and may show interest in representing you. Well, then you've got to get over here, you've got to go through that 01 hurdle, and, well, the 01 really doesn't figure, definitely doesn't figure for theatre. You have to have a green card in order to get your equity card, your AEA card, to work legally here as an actor. Here in New York, the energy is quite extraordinary. It's buzzy, it's high octane, and it doesn't exhaust you, it actually energizes you. At least this is what I find. So what does an actor face when he comes here? Well, I'm going to be brutally honest with you, pretty much the same issues you face with the Los Angeles. Yet again, you don't really get an opportunity out here if you don't have an agency or a representation already who can introduce you to an agency management in New York. But indeed, when you are over here, there's the extra avenue you have in New York that you don't have in Los Angeles. Yes, as I said, there is great theater in LA. It's not the same marketplace that you have here in New York. In fact, New York's sensibilities and sensitivities within the industry are very similar to London. You notice that immediately, the difference between the casting directors. Casting directors go to theater to seek talent for the TV shows and the films that are casting here in this city. As soon as I landed here, I hit the deck running, and I simply haven't stopped. In 4 months, I had more meetings, booked more work than in the 4 years I was in Los Angeles. Within about 3 weeks of my arriving, I booked a wonderful guest role in The Blacklist opposite James Spader. The following month, I booked a fantastic co-starring role opposite Jamie Bell in The Term. All these theater auditions I was suddenly going for, which obviously didn't exist in Los Angeles. Not only Broadway theater, but off-Broadway, off-off-Broadway. Great independent film industry here. So much production of TV out here on the East Coast. There are less commercials done here than in Los Angeles. That's one thing you will figure out and discover. When I was in LA, I was sometimes doing two or three auditions a day for commercials. Here, it's more like one or two or three a month, depending on the season again. Work on your American accent. It is very important. And not just one, not just the general, but the Southern accent, New York accent, as well as the Midwest accent. That obviously increases your opportunities of work out here. Since I have been over here, I've been engaged for my Russian, my German, my French, my American, my Polish, Irish, Scottish. Funnily enough, I've yet to be engaged for my British accent. Find your community, create a community. I've been asked to create Brits in New York out here, sister to Brits in LA. So check the link down below. If you're coming out here to visit, if you come out here regularly to work, if you're coming out here to check out the city and look at the opportunities to move here, we'll be having our first gathering or brunch in this coming month, in May. I'm also in the throes of helping British Equity set up a presence here with other British Equity members and to become British Equity ambassadors here in New York. The St. George's Society, it's a community for Brits, and it also has a charitable arm as well, similar to UCares in LA, in Brits in LA, to cater for any British citizen or dual citizen or resident here who may be having difficulty paying medical bills or have other issues that they need help with. The New York City ID card, this is a remarkable thing. It's free and it gives you free entry for a year into 33 museums, performing arts centers and galleries throughout New York. It gets you discount on movie theater tickets to as much as only having to pay $8 entrance fee to go and see a movie. It gets you discounts to Broadway shows, and at pharmacies around here gets you 95% discount off prescription drugs and other purchases. It's phenomenal. New York compared to Los Angeles, one big difference is it's much more expensive. That's something you will notice immediately. Most New Yorkers eat out, and you can eat out cheaper than if you actually go to the supermarkets and buy the food in. The other thing you will notice if you've been out to LA is, for the buck, you get a much smaller space as far as a rental apartment is concerned. If you go through a broker, you have to pay a brokerage fee. It's 12% of the year's rent you have to pay on top of your month's rent in advance, plus a month's rent deposit, plus they need to see 2 years history of your US tax so they can see what your earning capacity is, and also what's your credit. Well, if you don't have any credit, which will be the case because, as in LA, you've arrived without any credit. So some brokers, however, don't take a brokerage fee from the tenant. They take it from the landlord. They pay the fee, a finder's fee effectively, for placing you in their building. Another route is, because this is a student city, similar to most cities, therefore they will allow a guarantor, your parent or a family member back home, be that France or England or wherever else in Europe. Another route, of course, is not go via broker at all. Look online. You will find opportunities there where you can sublet. It's not legal, and you don't have the same coverage and protection that you do if you go through a broker. However, you can get an opportunity of an apartment for a lot less. Gypsy housing. This is fantastic. It's actually directed particularly towards artists, towards actors, people within the arts. Generally speaking, it's because they're actors who are going on tour, so they need someone to take their room while they're away. Or they've just lost someone, so they need someone to come in and replace, and that could be for a couple of months, or it could be for longer. You don't need a car. Whoa, that is fantastic. Straight away, for us, that is an $8,000 saving. Really is a city that never sleeps. Something we do not have in London is a subway system here that runs 24 hours. It's constantly on the go, and there is constantly something to engage you within the city, be it a jazz club, a dive bar, stand-up comedy. It's all go here. The fact, again, obviously this is a very special situation. We are on Liberty Island, but that was the big thing for me. Having spent so long living in Los Angeles, you walk out of your house, you go down to catch the subway, and it's like, whoa, who are all these people? There's so many people around me. And I love that. I love that. I love, you know, brushing shoulders with everybody, and already in a very short space of time, within 4 weeks, there were faces on my street that were recognizing me, and I was recognizing them, and it was, hi, how are you? How are you doing? Have a good day. And obviously you also get to know people when you're shoveling snow off your stairs and your sidewalk. Theatre. Amazing theatre on a par with West End, and a vast number of theatres very similar to London's West End, dotted around Manhattan and Broadway, and the what is the similar to Shaftesbury Avenue for us in London. So there is that, and off-Broadway and off-Broadway, I suppose, what are we looking at there? Those would be similar to the Almeida Theatre. Tricycle Theatre, the theatres that are slightly further out from the centre of London. 59 East 59, fabulous theatre right in the heart of Manhattan between Madison and Park Avenue South. Peter Thier is the executive producer and he really runs a tight ship there. It's a home for new writing, so it really resonates with me through 503. So in next week's episode, we're going to look at London and what that has to offer to actors coming over from America, as well as to the actors already based in that city and living in the UK. My name is John Perkis. Thank you for watching Diary of a Failed Actor.